So, hello students, welcome back to the final session of module 2, that is velocity and acceleration analysis of mechanisms using graphical methods. Okay, this is the last topic of this module, wherein we will learn very simple construction method which is used to find out the velocity and acceleration of the given mechanism. Okay, and this very important thing is, you should remember this, this method of finding out the velocity and acceleration of the mechanism can be applied only to the slide crank mechanism and not for a four bar chain. Okay, so let us move on with this. So using very simple construction methods, we are going to learn how exactly we are going to find the velocity and acceleration of the given mechanisms. Until now we have used two types of methods already. The very first method is velocity and acceleration diagrams. We used to draw velocity and acceleration diagrams with respect to the relative velocity method. And second thing is instantaneous center method. Now we will learn how to draw the velocity and acceleration diagrams and find out the velocity and acceleration of the given mechanism using the Klein's construction. So for that, let us take a slide crank mechanism. Let us consider a slide crank mechanism and let us try to analyze this and find out the velocity and acceleration, or let us just find out, or let us just draw the velocity and acceleration diagram using the Klein's construction for this given slide crank mechanism. Okay, so let AB, okay, always AB be the crank which is rotating at some uniform speed. Let us say clockwise. Okay, then there is a connecting rod connected to the crank, and that is CB. At the end of the connecting rod, there is a slider attached. So when AB rotates, automatically or obviously, this connecting rod will also move, due to which the slider will have a horizontal motion. So you know all these things. Now, how to construct, or what is Klein's construction, or how to construct velocity and acceleration diagrams using Klein's construction method? So first of all, let us draw a perpendicular line to point A. Or line AC. Exactly perpendicular line, let us draw. Okay, then we will extend CB so that it intersects the perpendicular line drawn from point A. And we will give a notation for that, M. Okay, let it be as M. Now, take B as center. Use the compass, take B as center and BM as radius, create a circle, smaller circle, Okay, why this circle is constructed, I'll tell you after we learn how to draw the velocity diagram. So, once it is done, now you can observe there is a triangle made, okay, that is ABM or BMA. Okay, you can see a triangle inside, BMA. So when I reconstruct this triangle separately, so that is B, M and A, this gives the velocity diagram. But yes, of course, this gives the velocity diagram of the given slider crank mechanism. Okay, you may think that how could be, okay, let us just discuss about this. So this is VBA, this is VCA and this is, oh sorry, this is VCB, okay, VC. Yeah, that is VCB, VCA and BM, okay, that line indicates VCB, okay, that line indicates VCB. So, now you may think that, how is this possible that, okay, the velocity direction, the direction of velocity of slider C with respect to A is vertical. So, it's not possible because the slider moves horizontally, so we have to draw the velocity vector horizontally. So now what we can do is just rotate this triangle to 90 degrees clockwise, that is, see, just like this. So rotate the triangle 90 degrees, so you can clearly see that AM indicates, the line AM indicates the velocity of C with respect to A. Whereas AB indicates velocity of B with respect to A, whereas BM indicates velocity of C with respect to B, So this is the velocity triangle, and this is how it is drawn using the Klein's construction. Okay, now we will see how to draw the acceleration diagram using the Klein's construction. So what I'll do next is, immediately after this, what I'll do is, I'll mark a center point on the connecting rod CB and give the notation as N. So I'll mark a center point on the connecting rod CB and I'll give a notation as N. So keeping N as center and B as and NB as radius, I'll draw a bigger circle. Now as you can see, this bigger circle intersects the smaller circle at two points, O and P. So this bigger circle intersects the smaller circle at two points, and let us name them as O and P. Now what we will do is, we will join O to P, or we will draw a line from O to P and extend it to the AC line, okay. So the line drawn naively, okay, cuts the connecting rod at R, let us say at R, and it touches the line AC at Q. So if you observe very closely, what you can see, a polygon, right? QABR or RQAB. Let us just reconstruct it and we will see what exactly it is. So this is the line RQ, this is the line QA, this is the line AB, and this is the line BR. So this gives you the acceleration diagram. How? Okay, let us see that. So see here, line AB, okay, line AB represents the radial component of acceleration of B with respect to A, correct? Radial component of acceleration for the link AB, and let us assume that there is no alpha given or there is no angular acceleration. So hence alpha will be 0, therefore AT of BA will also be 0, and this AR of BA itself, or the radial component of acceleration of BA, okay, or the link AB itself, becomes the resultant acceleration. Okay, so there is no tangential acceleration, but for the link CB or connecting rod CB, okay, there are two components, that is the radial component as well as the tangential component. Now this Q, okay, let us discuss about the slider. So QA or AQ, represents the acceleration of AC, acceleration of C with respect to A, or the link AC, or slider C, okay. So because it moves horizontally, so there will be no division of components in this, there will be no radial component or tangential component. Whatever we get is the resultant acceleration of the slider, and this line represents the resultant acceleration of the slider C, that is AC. Then when you consider RQ, when you consider the line RQ in the polygon, so it represents the tangential acceleration of link CB, because as you can see, it is acting perpendicular to the link CB. Whereas when you consider RB, it will give you the value of radial acceleration with respect to link CB. So you have ATA of CB as well as AR of CB. Now when you join B to Q, you will obtain the resultant acceleration of BC. Okay, so this is how, using Klein's construction, we can find out the velocity diagram as well as the acceleration diagram. Okay, so this completes this module. So whatever the problem is given in this, with respect to this Klein's construction, you can solve using this method only. So there is no need to solve problems, because normally in the examinations, Klein's construction or solving a problem for velocity and acceleration will not be given with respect to Klein's construction. But anyways, so you can solve two or three problems on this. That will be your assignment, or that will be your, okay, take it as a test or whatever it may be. So you can just use this method in order to find out velocity and acceleration for given slider crank mechanism. Okay, only slider crank mechanism. So thank you very much, guys. It's me, Veeresh Chandra MS, Dr. Veeresh Chandra MS, signing off. Thank you.